Maddie and Sullivan Chowdhury, I'm here to talk about a placement with you that I'm ongoing with you at the moment. It's been a week into it. Just going to run through a 15 minute interview with yourself regarding the placement, which is Dean's House Football Club. Some background knowledge about Dean's House Football Club that I've gathered through research, through the internet yourself, and also the community and the players itself. The club was established in 2002, June 2002, and the aim of the project of Dean's House Football Club is to provide the youth activity in the community, also to get the community together and participate in sport. As we know, and as you can tell in the training sessions as well, the club has grown rapidly over the years, as I've seen from some photographs and some video analysis as well. Obviously, it's one of the biggest clubs in the town. It's aged from 5 years to all the way up to 18 years, also with additional adult group as well. The teams, there's plenty of players in each teams as well. The teams are run by volunteers, coaches. All coaches and volunteers are CRB checked. Minimum FA level 1, Isabdi level 2, and Ashraf is level 2 as well. The club was granted FA chartered in 2006 due to the standards and policies of the club, which not many clubs get, so the club deserves good recognition and for its hard work as well, and all the hard work yourself and all the volunteers put into the club. And this is all run by volunteers, ensuring the success throughout the club through all the years from 2002 up to 2016. Going more on about to the achievements of the club, it was also voted Lancashire Community Club of the Year 2005. There's a lot of clubs around here, so to win the Lancashire Community Club of the Year was a really big achievement for Dean's House Football Club, and hope they're going to win a lot more. They also got to the Northwest Finals for the BBBC Sports Club of the Year, which is a fantastic achievement itself. And most importantly, and the standout here is they won the Queen Jubilee Award in 2012, and to win this award is significant and very superior, and makes this club stand out from all the others. And this was for the contribution to grassroots and community cohesion into the community. But the main subject around this is that the club wouldn't run without the volunteers, and the volunteers put a lot of work into this, like yourself, Hamad and H and Ashraf put a lot of work into this, and a lot of parents and a lot of volunteers outside the club do as well. The club has a lot of hubs, for example the Goshi Centre, which is based in Dean's House. Dean's House is open to the committee and also the Dean's House, and it caters for the community as a venue where young people engage and get together. Little venues go on, little events. I know in 2009 there was a trip down to Burnley Football Club to watch the England Under-21s. I remember back, I was part of that as well, getting down, and there was £1 to get onto the turf, which is a bargain for that price, and you, like yourself, you got that funding to reduce the price for that as well. So basically it's to get the young people to engage from all the community, from Nelson, Bradfield, Burnley, get everyone together. And the main aim is to reduce antisocial behaviour in the streets. And as you can see, from 2002 to 2016, it's rapidly decreased. The less use of vandalism. There's a lot more campaigns going on now, which is all reduced. Going on to the funding side of the club has accessed many resources from various partners, including the Prince's Trust, Burnley Borough Council, and also Lendlease. Also on top of this, it has been funded by external funds such from parents, other committees like yourself. I know yourself, you put a lot of money into this club as well to get it where it is today. I mean, none of this would have been done without any volunteers. So it's all been done through the contribution of parents, staff, and also from other resources such as the Burnley Borough Council and Prince's Trust and Lendlease. So that's just a quick brief overview of the background of the club and the aims and the funding and the achievements and the staff and the volunteers. Now we're going to move on to the strategies and development plans of Danes House Football Club. I'm going to break this down into sectors and talk about them briefly, and then go on to linking them into three sectors of the Burnley Borough Council, Lancashire County Council, and then nationally as well to Sport England, and then compare and contrast. So firstly, the strategic development plans of Danes House Football Club is to promote and increase participation in sport and physical activity, working with the diverse ethnic groups and communities of the borough. I can see this from just through my first placement session. There's a lot of whites, Muslims. There's a lot of these Asians. There's a lot of ethnic minorities in that football club, and it's great to see that a lot of people from different backgrounds are getting involved, getting to know each other's cultures, and just basically getting together and just having a good time. What it's all about. Also, it's targeting the deprived areas and to provide them with opportunities that they've never had before, and taking part in sport and taking more active role in the community. For example, I know Dean's House have done this through topic games such as Dean's House and Stonium, which have very less facilities in them areas. So, as mentioned before in the background research, you've created hubs such as the Goshia Centre, and also we use the Burnley campus here where I'm doing the interview, and we also St Peter's where we did a midnight league and all these organisations that took place. So this has been targeted to the parents, and it's looking good for the club. Also, number three, providing mentoring, support and capacity, building opportunities for all the residents of the borough. And this is done at gathering one-to-one. This is done at the Goshi Centre, where a lot of the committees went last week. A lot of the committees, I saw H having a one-to-one with another participant, having some difficulty with some situation, and it was great to see that these things are being done. So having one-to-one, so each person's getting plenty of care and plenty of recognition, so that's great to see. Acting as a member for local people who wish to become volunteers and access to opportunities and resources. This is done as there's a lot of committee members, so there's a lot of plenty of people to talk to, so there's not a lack of resources, so this is good. Also number five, to support groups, schools, coaches, set up sustainable projects. I know we go out to Borden Primary School, you go to Sir John Thursby, there's a lot of after school clubs, so there's plenty of projects. Also there's summer camps, we go on residential trips, we did one in 2012 to the army, it was a good taste today. Number six, to ensure safety of all volunteers, coaches and participants, and also DBS, like myself, given my DBS, I've been CRB checked, because obviously working with the children, I know all staff are CRB checked as well. It's one-to-one coaching, so all participants are looked after. There's no danger. I know, like myself, when we took out the first placement session, he asked me to do a risk assessment, and the risk is obviously very low on all sectors of the risk assessment, which is very good. Also, lastly, to enhance employment opportunities into sports. This is done through taster days, also when people are starting college, starting university, Danes House Football Club are there, just letting them know that the club are in the community, they're more than welcome to come down to the hub, come down to the club, come down to the training sessions, come down to the game days, which are done at Prairie, Townley and Burnley Football Club. Now moving on the priorities of the Burnley Borough Council and the strategic plans of what the Burnley Borough Council and how this links in with Danes House Football Club. Broken this down into three sectors, so we can link them back into Danes House Football Club. The main aim of the Burnley Borough Council is basically to get the youngsters off the streets and into sports, which is the main, and this is done through the Active Streets Programme. It's a 5-year scheme from 2013 to 2017. It's funded by the Big Lottery Fund, and it's used to help young people develop skills and it's aimed towards the 14 to 25 year olds. This has proven to reduce antisocial behaviour from 2013 so far, and they're working with many communities and agencies such as Dinsdale Football Club, which have done a lot of work on that. Moving on to the Lancashire County Council, it's Lancashire Sports Foundation, which is also run from 2013-2017. The aims of this is to grow, retain and improve. And this, the structure of the Lancashire Sports Partnership is a core team, clubs, is local authorities, private sectors, volunteers, national governing bodies. Also, it's run by the Lancashire Council rate and schools and clubs. And the aims is to increase and sustain participation in and widen access to sport and physical activity across the country. And this is the Lancashire County Council. Now moving on to Sport England, basically it's got four aims: to enhance social, cultural and well-being, provide opportunities for young children, improve community safety and improving health of the nation. Now looking back to Dinsdale Football Club, I've compared and contrast some of the priorities of these three sectors into Dinsdale Football Club. For the Burnley Borough Council, I can see that engaging the young people into developing skills links back to promoting the increase in participation in sports and physical activity, working with the diverse ethnic groups of community of the borough. I can see that Dinsdale's have been doing this, as obviously and clearly in the first training session I saw, and obviously from previous video analysis, I can see a lot of ethnic, diverse ethnic minorities in that football club and organisation, which is great to see. So it is linking in with the Burnley Borough Council and their strategic plans as well. Going on to the Lancashire County Council, one aim that it works on is the structure of the Lancashire Sports Partnership, local authorities, core team, also working with the increased participation in sports and physical activity. It's working with a lot of diverse ethnic groups, which are two quite similar targets. And nationally, it's looking at, as a member for local people who wish to become volunteers, access to opportunities and resources. It's providing opportunities for young children, aged 5 to 18, like I said. Got plenty of opportunities going through Monday to Friday and Saturday to Sunday over the weekend after school hours as well. Also, it's ensuring safety of all volunteers, coaching participants and DBS checks. It's improving the community safety, all the checks are done. So that side, to link in nationally, Dinsdale Football Club is looking at, it's meeting a lot of the criteria of the Burnley Borough Council, Lancashire County Council and Sport England. So as a whole, Dinsdale Football Club as an organisation is looking very positive of where it is today in 2016. Now moving on to the development issues of Dinsdale Football Club, and in order for us to move forward in the way that we have to, the work that we've started recently, and that I look forward to working on with yourself in the next couple of months, we need to establish a base in the community as a partnership with an organisation. I've noted down could link into development of the FC with an academy, Dinsdale Football Club. It could turn into academy, linking in with Burnley Football Club, as it's the main football club in Burnley, and there's a lot of progression there. There's a lot of footballers that have come in to Dinsdale Football Club, given recent talk to the children, giving positive feedback after their role models, motivating these children to do well in their school and sport careers. Also, the issues that we've got in Dinsdale Football Club that I've noted is the issue of females and special needs. Just note from the first training session, there's not many girls training, and I'd like to address this issue with all the girls' school. And I know there's a girls' school in Burnley, and I know there's a special needs school in Ridgewood, which is in Sir John Thursby. And what I realise is not many, in this area there's not many facilities or not many opportunities for these children, especially the females, the Muslim girls. They can't really go to a gym where men are training due to religious reasons. So therefore they're restricted in this sense. So I think we could do more about this situation. and I hope we improve on that.
Fantastic. I think it's only when you hear it from somebody else you realise how much is actually going on, and I think you reminded us of all the good work that all of our volunteers are doing, so thank you for that. And one of the areas that you touched on about the girls in particular, that is something that we're hoping to launch in the next couple of weeks, so we are working on that to try and get more and more girls involved.
Also, just linking on to that as well, a plan that I've got in mind for the females with special needs is we could go around to universities. Like myself, I've witnessed we have a lot of coaches that are advanced in these areas. For example, I've got an FA level 1 in wheelchair basketball. So if we went around to Ridgewood and see how we checked everything, we could go do after school activities to the people that are not participated in sports, and I could do a wheelchair basketball session. For example, every Thursday or Wednesday. And also on the female side, same again, we can go down to universities, find female instructors, do gym inductions, get these girls and get these females, all these females, not just the Muslim girls, get them all into sports, same as the boys, because obviously there's a lot more males out there participating in sports than the females. So this is an area where we can look at as well and bring in more female coaches, and get them doing the level 1, level 2, also enhance Dundas Football Club as well, kind of broaden thingy, and I think that's where a sector where we can improve on as well. So we could go on a tour around to the universities and colleges, find out who's got an FA on level 1 or level 2. If not, maybe we could put some funding into that and try getting some of these girls into the FA level 1, level 2, and then qualified in these areas.
Yeah. Fantastic, sounds like a great idea, and hopefully you'll carry on volunteering and helping us.
Thank you very much.
Cheers. All right.